Sampo Group CEO Torbjörn Magnusson. First question, could you elaborate what happened with the Nordev write-down?
Well, pleased to talk to you. I think one has to remember the most important thing about Nordea before we start talking about the write-down or the impairment, which is the technical term. Nordea is doing really well, isn't it? Since Frank Vang-Jensen took over the helm 18 months ago, Nordea has proceeded towards their targets as a clock, with determination all the time, every quarter. And we're really pleased to see that and have every confidence in Frank and his team that they will continue. Right. Then there's a book value in Sampo, which has to increase because there is a ban on dividends or a recommendation against dividends. So for technical reasons, that one goes too high. And we have just fixed that today. And it has no effect on our solvency. It's an extraordinary item, so it doesn't affect our dividend. It's a technical issue.
So it doesn't affect your cash flow,
no.
So to speak.
No.
Then the second question, how would you describe your last quarter?
Well, it's very pleasing. I'm very proud of it. It's been a difficult year for all of us, I think, with COVID-19. And most of our employees have worked from home. We have done really well. We have increased even further customer satisfaction. Employees are working hard with energy and succeeding in the markets. So it's been a very good year. And also in the last quarter, we grew more rapidly than GDP. And our combined ratio, the most important key performance indicator for us, was extremely low. And that's good.
I could ask more about what was driving the stellar results in If.
I think that is the result of years and years of investments in digitalization. These are now mainly digital markets, in employee energy and culture and working as professionals in the insurance market. So it's been a long journey and we improve every quarter.
Then about If's guidance, you're expecting combined ratio of 85%. That's quite low. So what's behind this very bullish guidance?
Well, that's the same answer again, isn't it? Because since we have built the foundations of a really strong company, we feel confident that we can predict that we will come under 85% combined ratio. And yeah, there you have it.
Okay. There's been a lot of criticism towards Sampo's perhaps vague communications of its actual strategy. Somehow even said that, quote, it seems Sampo's management is not that concerned with investors understanding the strategy, end of quote. Are you happy with Sampo's communication?
I'm not sure that I agree that there's been a lot of criticism, but we listen to all investors. Obviously, we try to improve. And to make sure that we are absolutely clear, we have a Capital Markets Day in 2 weeks' time. And I hope that when we leave that, everything will be explained. And as I said, absolutely clear to everyone that is there. Welcome.
Thank you. About your dividend, for some reason, there still seems to be some confusion about your dividend policy in the market. What message will you tell to investors with your dividend proposal?
Maybe it's not that difficult to understand that we had a new dividend policy last year and it was a change. So maybe that is understandable that there's still not confusion, I don't think, but discussions around it. And as you will have seen, we now have a dividend proposed of a 170, which is funded, which is natural from our insurance operations mainly. And well, there you have it.
Now we are free to talk about Hastings, which we weren't in the last interviews. What were your motives behind the acquisition?
Well, I think Hastings is a really good fit with us. We had followed the company for a long time. The stock market had not enough trust in the company, but we believed in the plans that they had. They operate in a really good market, a segment of the market, which we find interesting, digital and very price intensive. And we like the culture of the company. It's very similar to our own. It's hands-on management. It's very customer-oriented and it's very efficient, low costs. And we can see synergies between our operations in the Nordics and Hastings. So that's the background.
Could you be more clear what sort of synergies you're expecting from Hastings?
They are exceptionally good at rapid price changes to reflect the optimal pricing in the market, something that we haven't really done in the Nordics yet. So that is a step for us where we could jump ahead of any competition here. And then, of course, in the Nordics, we are very good at bundling and selling more than one product to each customer. And maybe that is something that could benefit Hastings.
So you're like sharing the best practices,
yes,
between different parts of the company.
Then there's some obvious things like reinsurance. They buy a whole lot of reinsurance. We did that when If P&C was started with Sampo many years ago. Mm. And then gradually we reduced that and kept the profits ourselves rather than give them to reinsurers. So that's natural.
In your CEO review, you said, quote, Hastings Group provides a new avenue for long-term growth, end of quote. Could you elaborate what does this mean?
They operate in a growth market. The UK market, digital market for motor insurance and home insurance are growing ones. And Hastings have a really strong growth record. If you go back in time, last year they grew by the number of policies by 8% in 1 year. So it is a growth market and they are winning in it.
Do you see Hastings as a growth platform where you can maybe make new acquisitions?
Not really. I think organic growth is the main path forward for Hastings.
Does it move the needle for Sampo, which is quite a big company, and Hastings is not that big, I think?
It doesn't move the... It's not like a transforming acquisition. It's something that fits really well, but it's not tiny either. So it's in between.
Okay, and then the last question. You have now begun your exit process in Nordea. Could you paint us a picture of how you use these proceeds from the sales?
Well, we had just acquired Hastings when we sold down in Nordea, and we were able to strengthen our balance sheet with the proceeds from that. So that's what we did.
Could you elaborate more, or what are your thoughts on capital allocation?
Well, the capital allocation, that's another word for a strategy of the company. And obviously we are working towards a more insurance-focused entity as we speak. But strategy is for the capital markets day. So again, you're very welcome to come there.
Well, thank you. We're waiting for that. Thank you for the interview.
Thank you.